On July 1st, 1776, as John Adams rose to deliver a speech to the Second Continental Congress in favor of American independence, a bolt of lightning shot down from the sky, filling the air with ominous blue light. A bad omen for those delegates yet to decide if breaking away from Great Britain was a good idea. The Revolutionary War had been raging for more than a year, but many Americans had chosen to fight only to secure colonial representation in the British Parliament, not full-blown independence for the colonies. But just a few weeks earlier, on June 7th, Virginia delegate Richard Henry Lee became the first politician in U.S. history to formally present to Congress the idea of American independence. And those who agreed knew they would have to act fast to make that dream a reality. So they commissioned a team of top rebels to put Lee's ideas down on paper and assigned Thomas Jefferson, the finest writer of the five, as the document's chief author. Jefferson eloquently and passionately summarized why the colonies had gone to war with Great Britain in the first place, what they wanted to achieve, and why they couldn't do it alone. Addressing a global audience, Jefferson effectively put out an SOS call to other nations sympathetic to America's cause, yelling, "We need your help to make this work." On July 4th, 1776, the Declaration of Independence was approved by Congress. And within months, copies had circulated all around the world. France soon declared its recognition of and support for the United States, triggering what would be the World War for America's right to exist, a war it finally won in 1783. So, why does this matter? The Declaration of Independence was the first ever document to cement equality into the founding principles of a nation. It helped to bring the colonies together during a national crisis and strengthen their resolve in the fight for freedom. But it was by no means perfect. How could all men be created equal in a country built on the profits of slavery? How do you think the ideas of equality expressed in the Declaration of Independence affect you today?